Hi friends, very good afternoon. Yes ma'am, please drop a confirmation message. Is everything is good to go? Yes. Welcome back to Let's Crack UPSC CSA English with India's largest learning platform An Academy. Let's crack it. From the words of DL ma'am as well as from An Academy. Yes. What all you will get under An Academy platform? Needless to say, daily live classes, isn't it? Yes, every day sharp 2 p.m. You can catch your DL ma'am YouTube platform. What is the best part of it? Yes, you can chat with your educator, engage in discussion, ask your doubts and answer polls all while the class is going on. Live test and quiz. Yes, my dear friends, just 1 week is left for your prelim 2020. I know how much you will be. Of course, definitely you are confident enough and also we have little bit stress. Okay, don't worry. Let us make some effort how to de-stress that. Okay, last thing, what you have to do in the last 1 day? I will share some important inputs in today's session, at the end of session. Okay. Structured courses. Yes, my dear friends, I can confidently say that all of our courses are so structured in line with your exam syllabus in order to help you best prepare for it. Isn't it? That's why I said it is OSS for your PMI. One-stop solution for your prelim, names and interview. Yes. Unlimited access to unlimited courses. What do you have to do? You have to do only one thing. One subscription gets you access to all our live and recorded courses to watch from the comfort of any of your devices. In order to avail that, first and foremost, you have to download the An Academy learning app. Yes, ma'am. This is me. This is your DL ma'am. Yes, I'm Dhanlakshmi. I'm senior, top, a verified and a very passionate educator. Yes, my dear friends, my passion for teaching is a never-ending process. You all know by this time because you are traveling with me for the last 7 months, 7 to 8 months, isn't it? See, apart from this, I will also want to share some more information with respect to myself. Yes, my journey with UPSC is a wonderful journey. Of course, I am also a very common person before I stepped into civil service examination preparation. Indeed, of course. UPSC CSE preparation. Whereas my journey with UPSC has groomed me as a perfect human being. This is the only field where I get to know many things. Apart from my knowledge enhancement, I also able to handle issues in a very dignified way. So the beauty, you have huge benefits when you prepare for civil service examination. So please thoroughly enjoy your preparation. It's really, really going to be a game changer in your life. Yes, my dear friends. I have stepped into civil service 2004. Yeah, of course, I'm a Vajran student. I have more than decade-long rich experience in teaching for UPSC CSE category. Yes, my dear friends, 13 years experience. I'm a senior most educator in offline platform. My credentials. I have a huge profile. To name a few, I'm a Group 2 officer. I cleared my state service. I have also cleared other competitive exams. To name a few, I have cleared more than 7 to 8 other competitive exams. Whichever exams I apply, I appear and apply. What is this? You can ask me, ma'am, is your job is to just sit and prepare for competitive? No, my dear. I did only one preparation. That preparation is for UPSC CSE, which has gained me. I have learned a lot from this, which has helped me to clear all other exams, which I have just applied and appeared. So this is the top of all exams, mother of all exams. Once if you are thorough with these exams, once if you know how to prepare for this exam, definitely it will not leave you in an empty hand. So this is very sure. Give your heart and soul for this preparation. Enjoy your learning on a daily basis. My credentials specific to civil service. I have appeared twice in UPSC CSE interview with 6 consecutive mains. Yes, I have cleared prelims 6 times in a series. Last 1 week, of course, today is the last class with respect to prelim inputs. After I'm doing 1 to 50, I'm also going to share a very, very important inputs respect to prelims. Okay. Apart from my unique way of teaching and coaching, I'm well known for my mentoring. Yes. For the last 12 years, I have mentored more than 25,000 aspirants who have been preparing for civil service examination. I have produced All India rank also. Yes, like rank 38. Many ranks I have produced. I have a huge track record. The best thing is that I happily say that many of my students are working as an IAS and IPS officers across India. You can reach your DL ma'am by using the code DL10. You have any doubt with respect to subscription details? Yes, you can reach me through Telegram channel. Here my number is there. Join my Telegram channel so that you can get my number from there and you can reach me. And also, you have you log into my profile in an academy. Don't forget to follow me there. You get to know more about me. Yes, ma'am. Prepare with the top educators. Indeed, is a blessing, isn't it? All the best brains are found under one roof, and needless to say, that roof is an academy. To name a few, Mrunal Sir, Roman Saini, Ayush Anghi, Sudarshan Gujjar. The list is endless. Comprehensive syllabus. Yes, my dear friends, this is the page. This slide gives you an idea about what are all the ongoing classes and what are all the upcoming courses for this, to this huge list. 15,000 odd courses, 130 more courses are going to get added in the coming week from the month of October. Yes, so everything is available for you. Everything is there readily available. Okay, it is only you should know how to utilize this platform to the fullest. One subscription make unlimited benefits. Yes or no? What are they? You can learn live from the comfort of your home, sitting at your home, at your home, at your place, at your favorite desk, at your study room. Yes, you learn everything. Unlimited access to all courses, top educators of India, all the best brains, all the subjects experts are found under one roof. Exhaustive coverage of syllabus, regular doubt clearing sessions, live test series, study material, answer writing sessions, and mentorship and guidance. This I keep on doing in my AMA sessions. Yes or no, ma'am? On and off. At least fortnightly once I used to conduct one or two sessions. In order to avail all these benefits, you have to do only one thing, that thing also at the priority. Yes, because there is going to be a price hike. Yes, ma'am. So please don't waste your parents' money by going for 1 month, 3 months, 6 months. In no way it will help you. It's simple thing. Go for a smart decision. Yes, this field requires a 1.5 years to 2 years preparation. Okay. So in order to attain the course, in order to attain the dream destination, we have to fulfill the requirements. Based on the time factor and the huge monetary benefit, really this is a huge monetary benefits. For the entire 24 months, 12 years period, you are going to pay only 64, that too after using your DLMAM code DL10, 10% instant discount, you have to pay only 57,600. So go for a smart decision, wise decision. Above all, it should be a timely decision. Why? Are you ready to pay extra 15,000 for the same duration, for the same course? No, we are not now, because the offer is going to end. So please be smart enough in doing. Next is, ma'am, what is the difference between the plus and the iconic? Yes, my dear friends. Iconic. Yes, this is you. Okay, my aspirants, and this is a person who have already sailed through this difficult terrain. Successful people never reach their goals alone, isn't it? This is very true, very true. Of course, the entire credit goes to you, but during the time, during the preparation time, until you reach your dream destination, somebody has got to say you what to do, what not to do, and how to do. Why you need somebody to say this? You can simply ask me, no, ma'am, I can manage it of myself. Very well, we can manage, but it is a time-consuming process. Because this is a field where we tend to make many mistakes. So the mentoring is purely for, in order to minimize our mistakes and maximize our success. Yes, time is very important, isn't it? We want to clear maximum, of course, we want to clear in the first attempt or maximum at the second attempt. We can't spend more time on that, isn't it? So taking all these into consideration, it is always good to have each and every civil service aspirants. It is always good to have one mentor for you. This field definitely require a mentoring. Yes, ma'am. So you all want to reach your dream destination. The journey in between your starting point and end point is needless to say. Is it better process? No, it is thorn of bushes. Okay, fine. I become a mentor because I wanted to give the thing I didn't realize is how much I would get. Yes, ma, are you looking for personal individual attention? You are ready to write answers, but you want somebody to evaluate. You want someone to help you in making a customized study plan. What is a weekly plan? Which subject I should start? What is the combination of the subjects I do? How to do everything? Personalized feedback. So what are all your expectations? All those things get fulfilled by enrolling Iconic subscription. Okay? Yes, ma'am. For the entire 2 years, the Iconic subscription fees as of now, in today's scenario, it is 99,000. After using my code, you get 10% instant discount. Yes, at last you have to pay only 89,100. Thank you, one and all. Best wishes for all of you. Yes, my dear friends, without any further delay, I'm going to begin. Of course, your DL ma'am has done the decoding 2019. Very good afternoon, Shubham. Very good afternoon, Omkar. Very good afternoon, Aslam. Yes, my dear friends, Can I begin the session? 2016 is over. I think as of now, we have gained the enough inputs. This is the last class of decoding UPSC previous year's question, which I'm going to do with respect to 2013. Is this fine? Can I begin? See the first question. What is this? We are also going to assess the pattern. Shall I begin without any further delay? Priority sector lending by banks, PSL in India, constitute the lending to agriculture, micro and small enterprises, weaker section, all of the above. Of course, it is for all of the above, isn't it? Yes, PSL for agriculture, micro and small and weaker section. Answer is D. Of course, this is a very, very, very easy question. Concept-based economy question. Am I right? This is not current affairs based. This is concept-based economy question. Yes or no, ma? First of all, in 1974, the banks were given a target of 33% as a share of the priority sector in the total bank credit. This is the history. Such an important concept. This was later revised on the recommendation of Dr. K.S. Krishnaswamy to 40%. So, from 33% in the year 1974, it has been increased. So, try to remember the recommendation. See, my dear friends, it is not that we are just getting an answer. We also should make an effort to learn the information, isn't it? That is what we are doing. Okay. So, on the recommendation, or whose recommendation? Krishnaswamy, how much money? It has been increased to 40%. This is the current target given to banks to disperse the loans to priority sector. Broadly, priority sector includes, very, very important, anytime you can expect this question. Even in 2020, you can expect this concept question, because this is concept-based economic question, not current affairs-based economic question, isn't it? Yes, ma. Please try to read along with me. So, which are the priority sector? Agricultural, agricultural finance, yes. Small enterprise, yes. Retail trade, yes. Microcredit, educational loans and housing loans. As per RBI, priority sector includes the sector shown in the adjacent graphics. At present, the domestic banks have to disperse 40% of the net bank credit to total priority sector. Out of this 40, very, very important question. Out of this 40, 18% to total agricultural advances. Okay, the foreign banks has to give a target. For priority, it is for the domestic banks, it is 40%, means for foreign banks, it is 32%. Am I right? 32%. Foreign banks has to give a target of 32% of the net bank credit to priority sector. However, there is no lower limit fixed for agriculture. Here it is fixed 18%. For here, it is not fixed for a foreign bank. Is this clear? Is this clear? Then, target credit to women beneficiaries is 5%. The basic objective of setting priority sector targets has been to ensure greater flow of credit to certain sectors where the credit would normally not flow to the desired. Normally, there is no scope for getting a credit limit, isn't it? So, when it has made it as a compulsory, so it is very sure that the women beneficiaries, they'll access, they can get an access to 5%. And for agriculture sector, it is a major domination. Of course, the major chunk goes to the agriculture, which is closer to 18%. Earlier, there was a demand from various stakeholders of the society that bank should be given a higher than the current 40% target of the priority sector. As of now, the targets have not been revised. See, from 33, it has been increased to 40. Now, there is also a call for, they wanted to increase this more. Still, it is on recommendation or discussion only. It has not yet came into action. Is this fine? So, very, very first question is an interesting question. Very, very, very important question. Weaker section. So, agriculture, after discussion, you know, 18% has to give. For women, it should be for 5%. And for foreign banks, 32%. Domestic bank, 40%. So, these are the inputs also we have learned along with this question discussion. Yes or no, ma? Learning the inputs is very, very important. Which among the following industries is the maximum consumer of water in India? Yes or no? Such an easy question. Common sense question. Which among the following industries is the maximum consumer of water in India? Engineering, paper and pulp, textile. Of course, all are water consuming. In this, the highest is thermal power. Needless to say. Yes or no? though industrial sector only accounts for the 3% of the annual water withdrawals in India, yet its contribution to water pollution, particularly in urban area, is considerable. See, industry is consuming only 3%, but it is pollution, it is like very much considerable, isn't it? In this question, you should also know that government has been planning to set up an agency on the lines of Bureau of Energy Efficiency to increase the conservation of the water. The focus initially would be on water intensive sectors such as thermal power plants, textiles, pulp, chemicals, etc. Of the total water used by the industry, thermal power plants are the biggest users of water and account for 88% of the total industrial water use. They are followed by, so what is this now? Thermal is 88%, engineering is only 5%, and pulp and paper 2.2, and textile is 2.7. Can we fill this? How much engineering? Engineering is 5, 2.2, 2.7. Okay, engineering is only 5%, pulp is 2.2, and textile is 2.7. Is this fine? So, which is highest? Undoubtedly, it is 88%. We haven't where. 88% it is there in the thermal sector, thermal power plants. Is this clear? Is this clear for everyone? Yes, ma. Next question. To obtain the full benefits of the keyword demographic dividend, what is this demographic dividend? Yes. Promoting, what should India do? You wanted to utilize the full benefits of demographic dividend because India is the only country which has more than 60% of the younger age. Of course, the age group of 30 to 35, isn't it? Yes, it is. In order to that, we want to promote skill development. Introducing more social security scheme? No. Reducing infant mortality rate? No. It has nothing to do with the demographic dividend because they are the working age population. Yes or no? Demographic dividend, profit. We are talking about the working age group, nothing to do with IMR, privatization of higher education, nothing to do. So the answer is very, very simple, promoting the skill development. Is this clear? Is this clear, ma? Yes. The survey says that India did not have as much growth in capital per worker as the other countries, such as China, South Korea, but has comparatively stronger growth than total fertility, isn't it? China grew because of more capital deployed as well as strong increase. Okay, this we will reduce. If India were to follow a similar path, it would need to increase savings and investment. Try to remember what we have to focus. We want to focus on increase on savings as well as on the investment, both of which will follow from the demographic transformation. Yes, but it will also have to increase the intrinsic productivity of job, that is for total factor productivity, TFP, which is nothing but total factor productivity. The survey says that the country can reap the demographic dividend by improving the total factor productivity. A transition from agriculture to non-agriculture sectors. What are the non-agriculture? Undoubtedly, it is manufacturing, service sector, and from unorganized to the organized. This can be done via skill development, and that is why skill development is key to reaping the demographic dividend for a country like India. Yes or no, ma? Yes or no? Is this question is clear? Yes, we have a huge potential. The problem is that huge potential is that our percentage of demographic dividend is very, very high. Where the problem lies? The problem lies in utilizing the resources. How to channelize the huge potential we have in our hands? The best way to channelize and utilize the huge potential is enhance the skill development. Is this fine? Because we wanted to move from agriculture to non-agriculture sector, such as we have to focus more on manufacturing and service sector. Is this clear? Is this clear? Because agriculture, primary, secondary, tertiary. Indian economy, we had a quantum jump from the primary to tertiary without undergoing secondary. Now it's time for us to focus on secondary as well as tertiary. Yes, because we have a huge demographic dividend. Is this clear? Yes, ma'am. Next question. In the context of cultural history of India, a pose in dance and dramatics called Tribhanga. Tribhanga. Tri. Three. Tree. Okay. Tribanga has been a favorite of Indian artist from ancient times till today. Which one of the following statement best describe this purpose? They are asking you what is meant by Tribanga. Okay. That's it. Okay. Now the answer is one leg is bent and the body is slightly but oppositively curved at waist and neck. With respect to the ancient dance and dramas. Just remember Lord Nadraja, Shiva, isn't it? Racial expression, hand gestures and makeups are combined. No. Movement of body, face and hands are used to express oneself or to tell a story. No. What they are saying? It is with reference to dance and dramatic. We have a clue here. Okay. A little smile, slightly curved waist and certain hand gestures are emphasized to express the feelings of love. No, this is all wrong. It is this is a very clear answer. One leg is bent. For dance, leg movement is very, very important. Yes or no? For dance, it is enough if you smile and if you show waist or something. No, leg movement is very, very important. One leg is bent and the body slightly but oppositely curved at waist and neck. Of course, you would have gone through this when you are reading your ancient. The technique of movement are built around the two basic postures of chok and tribanga. The chok is a position imitating a square, okay, a very masculine stance with the weight of the body equally balanced. The tribanga is a very feminine stance where the body is deflected at the neck, torso and the knees. Torso, have you ever heard this, ma? Have you ever heard this words? And tribanga consists of three bends in the body, at the neck, waist and the knee, and hence the body is oppositively curved as waist and neck, which gives us a gentle S shape, and it is considered the most graceful and sensual of the Odissi position. Is this fine? Of course, we have learned one more information as well. Is this clear? Next. Anibesan. Very easy. Modern India question. Anibesan. 1 and 3. Yes, 1 should come, 3 should come. Why? Anibesan responsible for the starting of home rule movement. Yes. Founder of the Theosophical Society. Who is the founder of Theosophical Society? Come on. When did it started? How do I discuss? It is Madam Russian lady and an American colonel, Blavatsky. Russian lady, Madam Blavatsky, and American colonel, Henry Alcott. Anibesant, she later joined it, isn't it? She later took the responsibility. So, she is not the founder of the Theosophical Society. One of the president of the Indian National Congress. True. So, it is only 1 and 3. Very, very easy question from modern India. Yes or no, my dear? Can I move on to the next question? Anibesan has become the head of the Theosophical Society in Madras, Adyar. It was a religious movement originally founded by Russian Madame Blavatsky and not Besant herself. The Theosophy preached a mixture of social reform, cultivation of occult practices and celebration of ancient Hindu wisdom that predated Western civilization. The first and the third statement are right. Yes, INC, of course, 1917 session, Indian National Congress 1917 session was headed by Anibesant at Calcutta. Is this clear? Yes, ma'am. Is my speed is fine? I think we are going in the right speed only. Next question. Very, very easy question again from modern India. Ilbert Bill controversy was related to removal of disqualification imposed on the Indian magistrates with regard to the trial of the Europeans. Yes or no? What type of question it is? Yes or no type question. Just remember those times, even in 2016, 2015, 14, 13 and all, dominated by this types. As time progress after 17, 18 only, 16 only, there is more inclusion of statement-based question. Yes or no? How many of you have analyzed that? How many of you have realized that initially the paper was little bit easy? Okay, it is more or like a statement-based, I mean like either yes or no type. The Ilbert Bill controversy was related to answer C. It has nothing to do with imposition of restriction to carry certain arms by the Indians. False. Imposition of restrictions on newspaper, false. Removal of disqualification. Okay. with respect to Indian judge and the European and the trial on the Europeans. Removal of duty, false. So it is very, very easy. 100% you have to make this question right, because such type question, majority of the time, they will be easy. Ilbert Bill is named after court, Ilbert, who was appointed as a legal advisor to the Court of Council of India. The bill was introduced in 1883. Try to remember, 1883, by Viceroy Ripon, who actually desired to abolish the racial prejudice from the Indian Penal Code. Ripon has proposed an amendment for existing laws in the country and to allow Indian judges and the magistrates the jurisdiction to try British offenders even in the criminal cases at the district level. But it was never allowed before. So naturally, the Europeans living in India looked it as a humiliation, and the introduction of the bill led to the intense opposition in Britain as well as India by the British residents. So it was withdrawn but was reintroduced and enacted in 1884 in severely compromised state. Is this clear? Is this clear? One lesson we are learning is that when some new imposition, when new rules comes in, see how strong the British residents and the British people, they opposed this. They were so strong and they made the bill to withdraw initially. So the Indian people, the Indian, our fighters, freedom fighters, on seeing the British, how strong they are towards any introduction of any new bill, they took this as an inspiration. Yes, we also have to fight till last. Isn't it? Of course, it was an effort of Viceroy Ripon. Next is seventh question. A rise in general level of price may be caused by increase in price. General level of prices may be caused by increase in money supply. True. Decrease in aggregate level of output. Very true. Increase in the effective demand. Whenever there is an increase in demand, there will be a price rise. Whenever there is an increase in money supply, there will be a price rise. Increase in the aggregate level of output. Yes. So naturally, all these three lead to the formation of rise in general level of prices. 1, 2 and 3. Such an easy question. Option is D. Yes or no, ma? I think majority it is concept based. The first statement is correct. Yes. Second and third, you can opt it simply by common sense. Decrease in aggregate level of output. Okay. Increase in effective demand. If there is an increase in effective demand, this would mean that too much money is chasing too few goods. This also causes inflation. Yes or no? Too much money, not with everyone, only with a certain group of people. Decrease in aggregate level of output. If there is a decrease in aggregate level of output, the money available in the economy will chase for goods and services which are now less available. This may lead to inflation. So this question is purely with respect to the inflation. Yes or no? Yes or no? Fine. Eighth question. Which of the following groups of items is included in India's foreign exchange reserve? Concept-based economy question. Am I right? Concept-based economy question. Of course, it is foreign currency assets, gold holdings of RBI and SDR. Foreign currency assets, gold holdings of RBI and SDR. So this is the answer we got it. Let us learn. It also contains what are the other things input we are learning from this question. What are the inputs? SDR, gold, foreign currency assets, reserve tranche position in the IMF. Of course, I know that it is purely concept based question. If you know economy, if you would have done these things, you would have very easily answered this question. Next one, ma. Next one. Which of the following is likely to be the most inflationary in its effect? See, seventh question they have asked with respect to causes of inflation. Yes or no? Which are the causes which lead to inflation? Am I right, ma? Please let me know. Causes which lead to inflation. Rise in general level of prices means the causes. But ninth question with respect to effects. See, inflationary in its effect. Repayment of public debt. Okay, how? Which one of the following is likely to be the most inflationary in its effect is repayment of public debt. government borrows from public. Okay, you have borrowed the money, but now you have to repay it. So that is an effect. How? If the government borrows from the public, the funds are diverted from the private sector to the government. Yes or no? Who will do the business? Does government do the business or private does invest on business? If the government is borrowing from the public, okay? So the money comes into the government, not it goes to the private sector. Yes or no? And there is a crowding out means shortage of the funds. Shortage of the funds for the investment. Government borrows from bank. What will happen when the government borrow from public? This is what we have discussed. Simultaneously, what will happen when the government borrows from the bank? If the government borrows from the bank, the same effect will be seen as the funds will be diverted from the banking system and the banks will have less money to lend. Of course, we are in need of money for investment in the business, isn't it? So we want the money to circulate or float. Having money in the government is like it is only for the public use. You can't make a profit out of it because it is not a business, isn't it? Only if it is in the hands of a bank or in the hands of the private sector, then we can multiply it. But when government borrows from the public in one way and other side it borrows from the bank, means what it will happen? Creating new money. This means borrows from RBI. So at the same time, if the government borrows from the central bank itself, three ways: borrowing from the public, borrowing from the bank, and borrowing from the central bank, that is RBI, by selling bonds. It receives new money from the central bank in exchange for the bonds. With this new money is spent, aggregate expenditure increases. Since in this case, funds are not diverted from the private sector, there is no crowding out. Friends, are you able to relate? This is purely concept-based question. Thus, the explanation, so there is no shortage of funds for investment. The explanatory effect is greater than when the deficit is financed by borrowing from the public. This new money increases effective demand, which if there exists unemployed labor. So don't worry. This is simple. Let us cut short this discussion portion. The simple is that they are asking what will happen, which one of the following is likely to be the most inflationary in its effects: repayment of public debt, okay, public government, borrowing from the public to finance the budget deficit, no, borrowing from the bank to finance a budget deficit, no, creating a new money to finance a budget deficit, no. Is this clear? Purely concept-based economic question. See, those time it was a conventional. They gave more emphasis on conventional. Current affairs was less. Yes or no, ma? I think if you read history properly, geography properly, economy properly, polity properly, prelims is not a matter at all. Isn't it? Because this was long back, 7 years back, 2013. Supply of money remaining the same when there is an increase in demand for money. There will be, what is an answer? An increase in the rate of interest. What they are saying? Supply of money remaining the same. So money supply is same. Okay? Remaining the same. When there is an increase in demand for money. So there is an increase in demand for money. MD is increasing. Money supply remains the same. They are asking what it will lead to. What it will happen. Yes, it's an easy question. There will be an increase in the rate of interest. There is a demand is increased, but we don't have a supply. So there is a mismatch between the demand and the supply. Yes or no? Very good, Hari. There is a mismatch between the demand. When there is a more demand, but you have limited resources, you have limited supposes, definitely we will increase the rate of interest, isn't it? So such an easy question. If the supply is same, then there is a more demand for money. Obviously, the interest rate will increase. Is this clear? Is this clear, ma? Falling level of the prices? No. How? Because supply is limited. Decrease in rate of interest, it is not at all possible. Increase in the level of income and employment, nothing to do with this. Is this clear? So the answer is very easy. It is option B. Next, fruits stored in cold chamber exhibit long storage life. Why? Why? Fruits stored in fridge exhibit long storage life. Buy a tomato, buy a fruits or vegetables. Okay, you keep it on outside. Okay, if you keep it in fridge, what it will happen? Yes, ma'am. You can guarantee, say, my vegetables and fruits, they come for 4 or 5 days. If you keep it outside, why? Such a simple common sense question. Because of rate of respiration is decreased. Is this clear? Is this clear? Is this a current affairs oriented question? No, it is such a simple common sense question. Fruits store in cold chamber, our fridge, exhibit long storage. Exposure to sunlight is prevented. No, concentration of carbon dioxide in the environment has increased. Nothing to do with this. There is an increase in humidity. No, rate of respiration is decreased. Yes, respiration is the chemical process by which the fruits and vegetables convert the sugar and oxygen into carbon dioxide, water and heat. Amazing, isn't it? Such a new input we are getting in. Respiration is the chemical process by which the fruits and the vegetables convert the sugar and oxygen into carbon dioxide, water and heat. Metabolic activity in the fresh fruits and vegetables continues for a short period after harvest. The energy required to sustain this activity comes from the respiration process. Respiration involves the oxidation of sugar to produce carbon dioxide, water and heat. The storage life of a commodity is influenced by its respiratory activity. By storing a commodity at a low temperature, respiration is reduced and senescence is delayed, thus extending the storage life. Yes or no? Yes or no? We all know that if we keep the fruits in the fridge, yes, it will be fresh for a longer time. But now only we learnt it, why it is, what is the process, what is the mechanism, what is the reason behind it. It is all because of the process of respiration. Is this fine? Yes. Respiration is reduced and delayed. That is clear. Involves the oxidation of sugar to produce carbon dioxide, water and heat. The storage life of commodity is influenced by its respiratory activity. Is this clear, ma? Next question. Consider the following fauna of India. Did I say? No matter it is 2010, no matter it is 2020, UPSC have the habit of asking the question from species, IUCN red list. Am I right? See, gharial, if you have attended my classes, now my students will easily say me, what is this gharial? Leatherback turtle, swamp deer, did I discuss in class? Yes, ma'am. Which among the above are endangered? Of course, this is a dynamic, it keeps changing. That time these two were endangered, 1 and 2, not swamp deer. Is this clear? That time is, we are discussing the question paper of 2013. This is not a static data, this is a dynamic data. Yes, gharial and leatherback turtle are only which comes under the category of endangered. Yes, gharial is the most uniquely evolved crocodile in the world, a specialized river dwelling fish eater. It is critically endangered, and the critical condition of the gharial reflects the endangered status of rivers. In India, we have only viable population in the National Chambal Sanctuary, spread across 3 states of UP, Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. Small non-breeding population exists in Sun, Gandak, Hooghly, Ghaghra rivers. Now it is extended. Very, very important. Now it is extended Myanmar, Pakistan, Bhutan and Bangladesh. With respect to leatherback, of course, loggerhead, hawksbill and leatherback are common names of the turtles found in India. What are the common names? Loggerhead, hawksbill and leatherback are common names of the turtles found in India. They are placed in the category, of course, it is a reptile. The 5 species are green turtle, loggerhead, olive ridley, hawksbill and leatherback. Of course, they comes in the category of critically endangered. Barasinga, swamp deer or barasinga is vulnerable, not endangered. Is this clear? Where it is found? It is found in isolated localities in the northern and central India and southwest Nepal. It is extant in Pakistan and Bangladesh. Please go and watch my session, ma. 4 classes, more than 4 to 5 classes I have done on IUCN red list. Okay, I have covered all the species. Please go and check in the special platform. Is this fine? is this fine? And more, one more important information, this is not a static, this is a dynamic data. Now, ball bearings are used in bicycle, car, etc. Why? Because, why do we use the ball bearings in cycle chain? We have a small balls. Have you ever noticed that? Why, ma? The actual area of contact between the wheel and the axle increased? No. The effective area of contact between the wheel and the axle increased? No. The effective area of contact between the wheel and the axle is reduced. Yes or no? Yes. The basic premise in friction theory is that anything that reduces the area of contact between the wheel and the axle will decrease the friction. In order to reduce the friction, either we'll pour oil in the wheel, cycle chain. Do you remember why? The friction, it produces a sound over there in order to reduce that. Since the ball is a sphere, it only contacts the wheel and the axle at a very small point, which helps in spin very smoothly. Yes or no? So the prime reason behind this, of course, this is a question picked up directly from your 6th to 10th NCERT. I think this is in your 7th or 8th NCERT, general science. Okay? From general science. So that's why I kept on saying in all my classes, I keep repeating this point. Every year UPSC directly pick questions from general science 6 to 10. It will be very easy. Mechanical engineering question, ma'am. But see Aslam, we are traveling like 14th question. As of now, we didn't see current affairs much. Yes or no? Yes or no? Current affairs domination, it has happened only in the 2016-17. Before that, it was balanced only. But now only papers are beginning more current affairs dominated. That time, it was only subject specific. Okay. Over to the fourth question. Which of the above are optical illusion? Which of the above? Of course, one is right, two is right, and four is right. Sun, size of the sun at the dusk. Color of the sun at the dawn. Moon being visible at the dawn. No. Twinkle of stars in the sky. True. Pole star being visible in the sky. No. So this again is a general science question. They have picked it from your general science NCERT. Till now subjects. Yes, ma. Size of the sun and the dusk. This is a correct option. Of course, the sun appears smaller during noon but larger at dawn or more clearly at the dusk. Yes or no? Yes or no? During noon, it looks, of course, definitely it is small and larger at dawn, at the sunset, and more clearly at the dusk. The apparent difference in size comes from optical illusion. At dawn, the sun is seen with the other objects on horizon and looks big. At noon, the sun is all alone in vast expanse of the sky, so it looks small. This is the reason. Second, color of the sun at the dawn. A halo is a ring around the moon or the sun produced by refraction, not reflection. It is produced by refraction of a light through a thin cloud of ice crystals. The halo had a red colors on inside of the ring, shifting to blue on the outside. Inside it is red color and it is surrounded by blue on the outside. There is also a correct, of course, the color effects such as red color of halo, the reddish color, sun pillars, etc. are all an outcome of optical illusion. Twinkling of stars is also an optical illusion caused by the refraction of a light while moving through various layers of atmosphere. Moon being visible at dawn. Moon appears larger than size. The statement is an ambiguous. Okay, so ambiguous statement UPSC never consider. So it is very clear, size of the sun at the dusk and color of the sun at the dawn. And what is the fourth one? Pole star. So only 1, 2 and 4. Of course, this is common sense related subject wise general science question. Okay, concept based. Is this fine? Shall I move on to the next? With reference to the history of the philosophical thoughts in India, consider the following regarding Sankhya school. This is directly picked from your 10th NCERT. Go and check 10th ancient history. It will be there at the end of the book. The last chapter of the book, they directly picked from your NCERT. Okay. So, what does this be? Two only. Sankhya does not accept the theory of rebirth or transmigration of the soul. What they are asking? They are asking you to find the correct answer. Okay, is first statement is correct? No. Sankhya holds that it is the self-knowledge that leads to liberation and not any exterior influence or agent. True. What is this? Sankhya means enumeration. The founder of Sankhya school of philosophy was Maharishi Kapil. Yes or no? There is some distinct feature of this philosophy. What is that? It strongly proponents dualism. Dualism. There are only two realities, Purusha and Prakriti. By Purusha, they mean consciousness, and by Prakriti, they mean substance or realm of matter. Third, Jiva or life is the state in which Purusha is bonded to Prakriti through the glue of desire, and at the end of this bondage is moksha. The above 3 points lead to the conclusion that this school does not believe in the existence of the God. We have 6 types of school. How many of you have covered this topic? 6 types of schools is discussed at the end, ancient India. It is there in your ancient India 10th standard book. Please go and check what are the different types of school philosophy. Very, very important questions. They kept on asking this question on a repetitive basis. Okay. Is this fine? Please go and refer this mark. Next. Can I move on to the next question? In the context of India, which of the following principles are implied institutionally in the parliamentary government? Of course, polity question. Again, it is a concept-based question. Easy question. 1 and 2 only. Statement 3 is wrong. Let me say. What the question is? In the context of India, which of the following principles are implied institutionally in the parliamentary form of government? Members of the cabinet or members of the parliament. Ministers hold the office till they enjoy the confidence in the parliament. True. Cabinet is headed by the head of the state. You can opt out because head of the state is the president and he or she does not head the cabinet. The second statement is correct and the first statement is also correct. So, 1 and 2 only. Cabinet is headed by the head of the state. So, this is again and again, it's very simple mark. 2013, it is purely till 2015, if I'm not wrong, it is only subject specific. That's why UPSC preparation students, they have the habit of saying, if you are strong with the 4 subjects, history, geography, polity, okay, economy, this is very easy. Those days, of course, I was a part of that. Those days, we never give much importance for current affairs. It is changed in order to break that monotonous. That time only they keep focusing more on NCRTs. Okay. In order to break that monotonous way of preparation, UPSC has started bringing a great change. Of course, it is a 360 degree change, that domination of the papers, current affairs oriented. Is this fine? Next. The annual range of temperature in the interior of the continent is high as compared to coastal area. What are the reasons? Come on, say me, what are the reasons? This question we have discussed already in class. Yes. Thermal difference between the land and the water. Coastal, marine influence, isn't it? Interior of the continent, which is far away from the coastal influence. Yes or no, ma? Annual range of the temperature in the interior of the continent is high as compared to coastal area. What are the reasons? Thermal difference between land and water. Yes. Variation in altitude between continent and oceans. No. Okay, they are asking you to find the correct answers. Presence of strong winds in the interior. Nothing to do. Heavy rains in the interior as compared to coast. No. Logically, this is all doesn't sound right. Yes, the right answer is the thermal difference between the land and the water. The first statement is correct, as we all know. One major factor affecting the distribution of temperature of the earth is distribution of the land and the ocean. Since there is a more land in the northern hemisphere and no more water in the southern hemisphere. Northern hemisphere, in short, it has been called as a land hemisphere. Southern hemisphere is an ocean hemisphere. Yes or no? Yes. And there is a big difference between the specific heat of the land and the water. The loss of the heat from the continent is bigger than the oceans. The continents get heated faster and get cooled faster in comparison to the ocean. Did I discuss all these points in the class? In simple language, I'll used to ask which gets heated fast, the land or the ocean? Ma'am, heating as well as cooling, both it is the land area, isn't it? Ocean, it is a large ocean surface, oh, huge body, it takes much time. Okay, because more than 70% it is a ocean space. This is the reason the temperatures of the oceans are moderate while that of the continent is extreme. The moderating effect on temperature on the land is due to the proximity of the sea is called maritime influence. Very easily I said, why? Because of the maritime influence. The increasing effect on temperature on the land at the interior of the continent is because of the continental influence. Is this fine? Yes, ma'am. Such an easy question. Let us move on to the next. Which of the following are the characteristics of Indian coal? Purely subject, not even current affairs. Till now we are reaching 18 question, of course. UPSC always have the habit of asking such like question. Choose the correct answer. 1 and 2. High ash content, low sulfur content. They said not in specific coal, they said specific to Indian coal. Indian coal characteristics, we have high ash content and we have low sulfur content. Okay, and low ash fusion temperature, no. Indian coal by their very nature or high in ash content but low in sulfur. It is it's coal in fusion, high ash fusion temperature about only 1500 degrees Celsius. Is this why? Low ash fusion temperature, it is not low ash, in fact it is high ash. So the third statement is wrong because it is a high ash fusion temperature of 1500 degrees Celsius. Is this clear? So statement 1 and 2 alone is right. Is this fine, ma? Simple. 19. Which of the following statement regarding laterite soils of India? Did we discuss this? Soil types of India, specific is laterite soils. Yes. What is an answer? 1 and 4. 1 and 4 is right. They are generally red in color. True. They are rich in nitrogen and potash. Are they rich in nitrogen and potash? No. They are well developed in Rajasthan and UP. No. Where do we have the laterite soil? Laterite soil we have in the area where it has a high temperature and high precipitation. Western side of Western Ghats. Meghalaya region, northeast. What is there to do with Rajasthan and UP? Yes or no? The prime condition for laterite soil is we need a high temperature and high precipitation. Yes or no? Tapioca and cashew nuts grow well on these soils. True. So any soils we have discussed this. Normally Indian soils are no. What did I say no? They are poor in nitrogen and organic content. Yes or no? Thus they are rich in nitrogen? No. Potash? No. So easily you can eliminate statement 2 and 3 by attending my class. Yes or no? In detail. Soil class itself, I have taken more than 4 or 5 subdivisions in detail, each and every topic we have discussed. So the answer is very, very easy. It is 1 and 4 only. Am I right, ma? Am I right? Yes. The second statement is okay. The third is fine. The laterite soil develop in area with high temperature and high precipitation. Did I say this or not? We get yes, ma. Eliminating 3 itself, you are getting an answer. Yes, Atla. See, you need not even 2 also, ma. If you eliminate 2 also, you will get the answer because ma'am has said no. What does this no? Majority of the Indian soil is low in nitrogen and low in organic content. Either you eliminate 2, you get an answer, or you eliminate 3. Okay, just by eliminating 2 alone or 3 alone or 2 and 3, you get an answer. Such an easy concept based question. Yes or no? Next. Laterite soil, what did I say? They should have a high temperature as well as the high precipitation. Is this clear? And of course, they are common in the hilly altitude area of peninsular plateau. Laterite soil is mainly found on the summits. Did I say this? They are found on the western side of Western Ghats, not on the eastern side. Be very specific. Western side of Western Ghats. Eastern Ghats. Rajmahal Hills. Vindhya, Satpura, Malwa Plateau, and abundant in Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Madhya Pradesh, and the hilly areas of Odisha and Assam. In the northeast, we have in Meghalaya also. Okay, Assam, Meghalaya, these region. Laterite soil, they represent intense leaching. When intense leaching will happen? When there is a heavy precipitation, heavy downpour, isn't it? Which lead to intense leaching due to heavy rains, due to which the lime and silica are leached away. Who are the couples? Lime, silica are leached away. Soil rich in iron oxide and aluminium compound, always Fe and Al. They are couples. Either they stay together or they leached together, isn't it? So when lime and calcium and silica, they are other pair. When calcium, lime and silica are leached away from the top soil, okay, leached away means they settle the second layer, B layer, which will be left at the top layer. In the top, it will be occupied by iron oxide and aluminium. Esonoma. In class, did I discuss, because they are the couples, either they stay together or they swim together or sink together, like Council of Ministers, isn't it? Yes. Iron oxide, soil rich in iron oxide and aluminium compound are left behind. The humus content of the soil is removed fast by bacteria that thrives well in high temperature. Is this clear? Are you able to recap the concepts what we have discussed? Just you say me, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. If you would have appeared in that year, means I would have made films easy, because it is enough if you are strong in the concept. Yes or no? All the questions till now we have discussed, they are purely concept-based question. Is this fine? Now, 20th question. Consider the following statement. What is this? Two alone is right. Natural gas occurs in Gondwana belt. False. Mica occur abundance in Kodarma. True. Darwar are famous for petroleum. Does Darwar are famous? Let us see. What is an answer? Answer is two alone. Okay? Yes. At one time, Kodarma was considered as the mica capital of India. Of course, Kodarma district and Lokai Indarwa area covers the southern part of Great Mica Belt of Jharkhand, Bihar and India. The rest of the two statements are naturally it is wrong. Yes, this is again a concept based question. 21. Consider the following crops. Can I move on? Can I move on to the next question? Consider the following crops. 1, 2, 4. 1, 2, 4. Wheat is not. Of course, we have an idea. Which of the following are a kharif crop? Very easy, na? Because we know what all comes under Rabi crops and which all comes under Kharif crops. Am I right? Am I right? Yes. Is rice is a Kharif? Is rice, what they are asking? C. 1, 2 and 3. Sorry. 1, 2 and 3, of course. 3. Is rice is a Kharif and wheat is a Rabi crops, isn't it? So, cotton, groundnut and rice are all an examples of Kharif crops, because wheat comes under Rabi. Am I right? Am I right, ma? Zayed. Also, you should have this list. So, such an easy question. Here again, this is a concept. Kharif crops. Yes, paddy, jowar, bajra, maize, ragi, tur, moong, urad, cotton, groundnut, sunflower seed, soya bean, black sesamum, Niger seed. Rabi crops. Wheat, barley, gram, lentil, rapeseed, other crops. The very important, please try to have the synopsis with respect to this topic. Many times they have the habit of you asking this question, what all comes under Kharif crops, what all comes under Rabi crops. Is this clear? Such an important question, and it is a very simple question. Only one thing we should do from our end is that we have to keep updating this. Is this fine, ma'am? Shall I move on to the next question? So all these three comes under Kharif. Wheat is alone is a Rabi. What are the other Rabi crops? Not only wheat, barley, gram, lentil, masoor, rapeseed, mustard, safflower and toriya. We also have other list. Okay. Next question. 22. Climate is extreme. Rainfall is scanty. And the people used to be a nomadic herders. The above statement best describes which of the following region? Come on, answer me. Did we do the GCLEO or not? Did we complete the GCLEO? I think you will answer me. See how easy the questions are. Yes, ma'am. Climate is extreme. Rainfall is a scanty rainfall. And the people used to be a nomadic herder. DCVE. Do you remember DCVE? Distribution, climate, vegetation, life and economy. Yes or no? Yes, ma. It is nothing but Central Asian steppe type of climate. So the answer is steppe type of climate. Is this fine? Yes. Nomadic herding or pastoral nomadism is a primitive subsistence activity in which the herders rely on animal for food, clothing, shelter, etc. They move from one place to another along with their livestock, depending on the amount and the quality of the pastures and waters. Thus, there is an irregular pattern of movement. Yes or no? Yes or no? Please answer me. When we come to the statement, yes, the climate is extreme. Rainfall is scanty. People used to be nomadic herders. The question say used to, not used to. Of course, Mongols and the question type. In Siberian, tundra may be opted out even if you take it used to be. Fine. So, central steppe type is this. So, simple thing. Let us reduce this discussion. Why? Because this question is directly picked from the major climatic types of India. Major climatic types of the world climatic types. World climatic types. Is this fine, ma? So, you are thorough with this, all the climatic regions. I know that. Please do the revision. Yes, ma. Anytime UPSC can revert back to the previous pattern also. But no way they will reduce the current affairs. Current affairs is very, very important. Next question. Can I move on to the next? Please let me know. Can I move on to the next? Consider the following statement. Again, this is the third question with respect to the inflation topic. What was the seventh question? First question with respect to inflation. They have asked what are the causes of inflation. On ninth question, they have asked what are the effects of inflation. Yes or no? Yes or no? And this is one more question with respect to the same topic. They are asking, so is again, what are the effects? Inflation benefits the debtors. Inflation benefits the bondholders. How could be? The first is right. Yes, ma'am. Inflation benefits the debtors. But inflation does not benefit the bondholders. Statement 2 is wrong. Why the government has introduced the inflation index bonds? If you talk about this, this question is a cakewalk. Definitely. So, just remember, the inflation was a very, very important topic. Not only that time, even now. You can expect the questions on inflation. Yes, what are the causes? What are the different types of inflation? Please try to have from the concept-based economy. I have a list which are the topics you have to focus on in that. Inflation is very, very, very important question. Next question. 24. Disguised unemployment. What do you mean by disguised unemployment? Generally means they are just simply asking. It is nothing but marginal productivity of a labor is zero. Marginal productivity of a labor is zero. Disguised unemployment is one of the major features of Indian agriculture. It seems that all members of the family are employed, but if one member is withdrawn, there is no change in the total output. The third statement, marginal productivity is low, is the correct. What is this? For example, an acre. Okay, it is a 5-acre land, and for this 5-acre, the acre is only limited. It is very, very small, and if you wanted to bring the desired output from this land by doing an intensive cultivation or it is enough if 4 people work on this land. It because the aerial extent is very, very less, so 4 people hard work or labor is enough. Okay, since you are finding your brother or your cousin or someone is also just remaining at home, okay. No matter how much maximum input you put, how much maximum effort you put, the maximum itself you yield from this land, the land capacity and other things only this much. Okay, your brother or your cousin, they are saying, chalo, I will also come and work. So, in the place of 4, you are adding one more person, 5%. Okay, despite adding 1%, it doesn't mean that your productivity will be more. Either you add this person or you remove this person, the productivity remains same. Yes or no? Marginal productivity of labor is zero. This is called disguised unemployment. See, Disguised unemployment is one of the major features of Indian agriculture. It seems that all the members of the family are employed, but if one member is withdrawn, there is no change in total output. If one member is withdrawn means if there is a loss, then there is a change. If one member is increased, there is a profit, then there is a change. There is no profit or loss on addition or deletion of one extra member means that is called either you do the work, no use. Either you divide, yes, ma'am. That is called disguised unemployment. Is this clear? Is this clear? Fine. Consider the following statement. The Council of Ministers. Which of the statement above are correct? True. 213. The Council of Statements in the center shall be collectively responsible to the Parliament. The Union Minister shall hold the office during the pleasure of the President of India. The Prime Minister shall communicate to the President about the proposal for legislation. True. Very, very easy question. The first is Article 75 clearly says that the Council of Ministers is collectively responsible to the Lok Sabha. Statement 1 is incorrect. It is not to the Parliament. Is it to the Parliament? It is for both houses or only for the Lok Sabha? It is for the Lok Sabha, isn't it? So, statement 1 is wrong. Of course, other two are right. It also contains principles of individual responsibility. It states that minister shall hold office during the pleasure of the president. True. It is the duty of the prime minister to communicate to the president all decisions of council of ministers relating to the administration of the affairs of union and proposal for legislation. Yes or no? So statement 3 is also right. Statement 1 is it has to be replaced by the word instead of Parliament, it is by Lok Sabha as per Article 75. Am I right, ma? Am I right? Is this clear? Please answer me. Yes, we have completed 25 questions. So please say me what is your opinion after traveling till 25 questions. Ma'am, paper seems to be easy, ma'am. From 1 to 25, just it is purely, it is a concept based. Yes or no? How many of you are attending the session? Please register your inputs. Please register your inputs now. Next question. B. Of course, 213. 213. Yes, Hari. What are the statements given above or correct? So, see, they didn't even ask incorrect also as of now. Isn't it? They have been directly making it was so easy. Those days, it was so easy to clear prelims. Okay, which of the given statement above or correct? National Development Council. NDC is an organ of the Planning Commission. Is it? Wait. The economic and social planning is kept in the concurrent list in the Constitution of India. True. Earlier period UPSC asked conventional topic. That is very true, Hari. The Constitution of India prescribes that Panchayat should be assigned the task of preparation. Yes, ma'am. Thank you, Navin. Task of preparation of plans for economic development and social justice. Okay, let me read your mindset now. Ma'am, if I were in that position, means prelim is nowhere a problem for me, ma'am. As you all other people are just saying wrong information, ma'am. Prelim is really easy because by the time I'm able to answer all these concept questions, I'm groomed in such a way, I'm doing my preparation in such a way that I'm able to decode the concept-based question. Yes or no? This is the feeling you have. Yes, I'm rightly reading polity. I'm rightly attending all the classes. So only one thing you have to do, one small changes you have to do for this present students. I mean this batch. This batch means after 2017 itself, there is a huge change. Just focus on current affairs. Conventional based current affairs. Okay. It is not conventional subject alone or current affairs separate. Both together goes hand in hand. Our preparation should be such that we have to give prime importance for current affairs and conventional. Then only we can qualify the upcoming UPSC prelims. Okay. Next ma, the first statement is the very preamble of the Constitution specifies the resolve. Yes, social justice. Third statement. Can I move on? I think this is a simple question. Okay, fine. 27. Consider the following statement. The chairman and the two alone. Okay. The chairman and the deputy chairman of the Rajya Sabha are not the members of that house. While the nominated members of the two houses of the parliament have no voting rights in the presidential election, they have the right to vote in the election of vice president. They are asking, find which of the above are right. Two alone is right. Why? Because the first statement is not correct, because it talks about the chairman as well as the deputy chairman. Vice president of India, in fact, it is an ex officio chairman of Rajya Sabha, isn't it? Vice president is an ex officio chairman of Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha also choose from amongst his member a deputy chairman. So because of this, the statement one is wrong. Second statement is right. How? President, elected members of parliament, MP from Lok Sabha as well as from Rajya Sabha, elected members of state legislative members, including that of NCT of Delhi and Pondicherry. Of course, vice president is elected indirectly by an electoral college consisting of members of both the houses of parliament. Very, very easy question. It's a direct question. Yes or no, ma? Very easy question. It is not the members of that house. Is this clear? Because vice president of India is an ex officio chairman of Rajya Sabha. Is this fine? Is this fine? Next. 28. With reference to National Legal Service Authority, NLSA, consider the following statement. Okay? See, both are right. Its objective is to provide free and competent legal services to the weaker section of the society on the basis of equal opportunity. True. It issues guidelines for the state legal service authorities to implement the legal program and the schemes throughout the country. Both the statements are directly right. Yes, ma. It is again, it's such an easy question. Of course. National Legal Service Authority has been constituted. Which year? Under the Legal Service Authority Act. Try to remember the act. Year, very important. 1987. To provide a free legal services to the weaker section of the society as well as to organize the Lok Adalat for amicable settlement of dispute. Every state legal service authority has been constituted to give effect to the policies and directions of NLSA and to give free legal services to the people and to conduct Lok Adalats in the state. Which year? 1987. So both the statement are right. Is this fine? Is this fine? Can I move on to the next question? Can I move on to the next question? 29. During a thunderstorm, a thunder in the skies is produced. They are asking, see, such an easy question. None of the above produces the thunder. This thunder is produced because of meeting of cumulonimbus clouds in the sky, lightning that separates the nimbus clouds, violent upward movement of air and water particles. Don't worry, I didn't touch this topic. Okay, I will do this. I will do this when I am going to do the cyclones, thunderstorms, tornadoes, everything I will discuss when I do my climatology. Okay, please wait for that. Thunderstorm results from the rapid upward movement of warm, moist air. Upward draft. It is called upward draft. They can occur inside a warm, moist air mass and at front. As the warm, moist air move upward, it cools, condenses and form the cumulonimbus clouds. You know, no warming of air. The warm, moist air, yes, it becomes light. It ascends. On ascending, it gets cooled. Condensation, cloud formation and precipitation. Condensation, what type of clouds it forms? Cumulus clouds. And then it leads to the precipitation, isn't it? Yes, ma'am. And it forms a cumulonimbus cloud that can reach an height of over 20 kilometer. The thunderstorms are associated with the cumulonimbus clouds. These clouds normally form on a warm, sunny days, but they can also be found on a cold front. Yes, thunder sound produced. The lightning generates between 100 million and 1 billion volts of electricity, can heat the air to around 15 kilowatts. The rapid expansion causes the shock waves. Thunder happens because the lightning would heat the air at a huge temperature and the air expands so fast that it makes a cloud clap of a thunder. So what are the answers they have given? It's not the answer for the occurrence of a thunder. It is happening because of the lightning would heat the air. Okay. The lightning would eat the hair at a huge temperature. The air expands so fast. It all happens in a fraction of time. The air expands so fast that it makes a cloud clap of a thunder. This is a separate process we'll be discussing. Don't worry, even if you're not able to understand now, don't worry. I'll do some demo when I do this concept class. Okay, now I don't want to rush up. I do some demo when I do the concept class. Next. 30th. Consider the following pass. Of course, it is a mass the following type. Yes or no? Sometimes or majority of the time, this type of question will be difficult. Don't expect that I will say easy. It will be little challenging. Let me check. Limbu, Sikkim. Okay, and 1 and 3. Okay. Dongaria, Gond, Odisha. Fine. Bonda, is it Tamil Nadu? We don't know. Karbi, Himachal Pradesh. It is recommended not to touch these questions because, as I mentioned you, we have, by this time, you are all very sure about the pattern of UPSC prelim question, isn't it? Always match or find the following pass. Majority of the times, there are 50-50 chances only. 50-50 chances only, so you must be little careful in this question. Let me say, yes, that appeared as Bonda, the most primitive tribal group in Odisha, not in Tamil Nadu. According to census 2011, the tribe has a population less than 12,000. Therefore, statement 4 is wrong. It is Bonda with Tamil Nadu. The answer is like. So it is normally, majority of the time, before you decide to touch the master question, master following or the pass, be careful. If you have an option, please push it to 15. 15 is a reserve, isn't it? Don't take a risk and increase your negative. Next, consider the following liquid acids. This is an interesting concept-based question. Correct sequence of these acids in decreasing order of liquidity. Decreasing order of liquidity. What they are saying? 4. 4 is the decreasing. First is 4. Okay. Then it is 1. Then it is 1. Then it is 3. And 2. So, first is decreasing order of liquidity. First is currency. Second is demand deposits with the bank. And third is saving deposits with the bank. And last is time deposits. So, currency, demand deposits with the bank. And saving deposits with the bank and time deposits with the bank. So, this is the decreasing order of liquidity. Is this fine, ma? See, currency is most liquid because you can use it as and when you want. True. Time deposit with bank. Fixed. You can't. And that means decreasing order. Okay. 4, 1, 3, 2. Super. So, this is a simple question. Here again is a concept-based economy. Very, very easy. In the context of the Indian economy, open market operation. What does OMO refers to? Yes or no, ma? What does OMO refers to? Of course, it is a purchase and sale of government securities by the RBI. Buying and selling of government securities by the RBI. OMO or conducted by the RBI. Via the sale and purchase of government securities to and from the market, the primary aim of modulating rupee liquidity conditions in the market. OMO or effective quantitative policy doesn't come under the qualitative measures. It comes under the quantitative measures of RBI tool in the armory of the RBI, but are constrained by the stock of government securities available with it point time. Is this fine? Very easy question. SLR, CRR, OMR, marginal standing facility, all these questions are concepts. Even they have asked once the repo rate. See how easy they have asked the question. So OMO, this is all a simple term, concept-based question directly from the economy, nothing to do with the current affairs. Okay? Is this fine, ma? Is this fine? Can I move on to the next? Under the scheduled tribes, okay? Under the scheduled tribes and other traditional forest dwellers, Recognition of Forest Rights Act 2006, Forest Rights Act 2006, who shall be the authority to initiate the process for determining the nature and extent of individual or community forest rights or both? Fine. It is nothing but Gram Sabha. Yes, section 6 of Forest Rights Act, which confers powers on the Gram Sabha to determine the nature and the extent of individual or the community rights. Nothing to do with State Forest Department, not to do with District Collector, Tahsildar or BDO. Okay, it is directly, it lies in the hands of Gram Sabha. Of course, this is a grassroots level approach. Okay, bottom up approach. Yes or no? Yes or no, ma? Please let me know. Can I move on to the next question? Yes. 34. Improper handling and storage of cereal grains and oil seeds results in the production of toxins known as aflatoxin, which are not generally destroyed by normal cooking process. Aflatoxin are produced by molds. The fungus Aspergillus flavus produces a toxic aflatoxin. This mold is found in soil, decaying vegetation, grain, cereal, say corn, peanuts, sweet potatoes, rice, and animal feed. It is believed that products contaminated with aflatoxin are carcinogenic to human, cancer-causing to human. Yes or no? Cancer-causative. See, just say me. Here again, we are having a many general questions. Now, it doesn't to do with any subject specification. This is a very general, and naturally, we know the answers of these type of questions. That is the beauty of that time. They have the habit of certain 4 to 5 questions, very, very simple. Very, very simple with respect to our day-to-day living. Okay. Next is 35. Economic justice as one of the objectives of the Indian Constitution has been provided in. Come on, how easy this question is. Preamble and directive principles of state policy. Yes or no? Preamble and fundamental rights, economic justice. Is it fundamental rights and directive principles? No, it is preamble and the DPSP. Yes, ma. Preamble, social justice in terms of social justice, economic justice and political justice. In DPSP, Article 38, to promote the welfare of the people by securing a social order permeated by justice, socio-economic and political, to minimize the inequalities of the income, status, facilities and opportunities. Yes or no? Yes or no? See how easy the question is? Yes, ma'am. Next is little bit tricky question. If you ask me, okay, this is the question deserved to be placed under 15. Deserved to be placed under 15. Let me say why. Let me say why. Due to improper, indiscriminate disposal of old and used computers or their parts, electronic waste, e-waste. Which of the following are released into the environment as e-waste? Select the correct answer using the code below. Just the same way, is this a question? To be touched, to take the risk, beryllium, cadmium, chromium, heptacollar, mercury, lead, plutonium. The answer is 1, 2, 3, 5 and 6. They are saying 4 should not come and 7 should not come. Just to say me, how many of us are aware of what all it comes under e-waste? Please give me an answer. I have some disturbance. Sorry for that. Heptacollar is an insecticide. You can arrive at the correct answers just by eliminating this. It has nothing to do with electronic products. So try to remove 4 in the option. Try to remove 4 in the option. If you are sure that this name is an insecticide, ma'am, without even knowing plutonium, you can get the right answer. Yes or no? But if you don't know, what will happen? We'll end up spending more than 70 seconds or 80 seconds on this question. What do you mean by 15? I'm new to class. Acha, Naveen, 15 means, come on Naveen, it's a very good question. I really appreciate your honesty and being very genuine here. 15 is ma, because we have a negative pattern. Okay, 100. We need not attend all the 100 questions, isn't it? We have to attempt only 85 questions. We have a liberty to leave 15 questions. Yes or no, Naveen? Yes or no? I have done the previous year decoding for the last 1 week. I have trained my students which are all the questions, which are all type of of the question, we can push it to 15. So that you need not touch that question, you can leave it and reduce the negative marking. Majority of the time, match the following questions. Or the correct pass, we have an option of only 50-50 making right. 50-50 chances. Okay. So don't take risk in these types. You please go and check my previous video. I have given enormous amount of inputs with respect to which are the questions we can reserve 115. Is this fine, Navin? Is this fine? So I have said this is the question. It is not recommended to touch and increase the negative. Rather, you push it to L. L means in the beginning only my students will mark L. This question, let me not waste the time, because I have also trained them. What is the nature of the question? That question deserves how much time, how much seconds, what are the pattern, what is the winning chances of that question? Everything in detail I have discussed. I have given more than 10 points. Am I right, Ma? So please go and check. I think now you understood. So these questions and match the following and current percentage based question or data based question, normally I used to say them not to touch. Okay? And don't increase your negative. Is this fine, Navin? Can I move on to the next question? So this is a question, unless and otherwise, if you know iptacloor is an insecticide, it is not recommended to touch and increase this negative. Next is, acid rain is caused by pollution of environment by. You just take what type of question it is, yes or no question. And this is very, very easy question. Just give me a moment. I have some irritation. That is so. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Okay. Acid rain. This is yes or no type question. 90 to 95% these types of question will be easy and you have to make this question right. It will be very simple. Very simple. Acid rain. Do you want me to say the answer? Yes, ma'am. It is nitrous and sulfur oxide. In our class, we have discussed in detail, isn't it? It is not because of carbon dioxide and nitrogen, carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide, ozone and carbon dioxide. It is N and S. Nitrous oxide and sulfur dioxide. Yes or no? Is this clear, ma'am? Is this clear? Next. 38. With reference to food chain and ecosystem. Food chain question also we have discussed already. Okay. Food chain in ecosystem. Consider the following statement. Which of the above statement given statement are correct? Okay. State 1 only. They are saying 2 and 3 is wrong. 2 and 3 is wrong. Food chain illustrates the order in which a chain of organisms feed upon each other. Yes or no? Tropic level 1. Tropic level 2. 3. And what is the maximum tropic level? It is only level 4, isn't it? Producers, primary consumers, secondary consumers, carnivores. This is what we have discussed in detail. Second, food chains are found within the population of species. It is only within the population of the species? No. A food chain illustrates the number of each organisms which are eaten by others. Which of the above statements are correct? One only, because there is a law we have. Just give me. Statement 1 is correct because food chain shows the order sequence of feeding. Food chains are not found within the population of species because technically food chain is the sequence of organisms through which the energy flows. If the species starts eating itself, then the flow of energy will not proceed. So statement 2 is wrong. Doesn't show numbers of each organisms. Yes or no? Such an easy question. Very, very easy question. In detail, food chain, food web, everything in detail we have discussed in our class. Yes or no? Please make an attempt to answer this question. Yes. National Park. Corbett National Park. Where it is? Kaziranga National Park, where it is? Silent Valley National Park, where it is? Which of the above pads are correctly matched? Corbett National Park. Just say me the state. Say me the state. Now they have asked with respect to the river. We wanted to know. I have some bad irritation. Please excuse me. Yes, ma'am. National Park. And the river. Okay, normally we have been trained, we used to prepare with respect to the national park and the state. National Corbett. Give me the answer. Where it is, Aslam? Kaziranga. Where it is? Corbett, Kaziranga, Silent Valley National Park. Ganga, Manas, Kaveri. Is this right? Is this right? Answer is D. Why? Yes, the first match is not correct because it is Ram Ganga, not Ganga. It flows through Corbett National Park. The second is not correct because Kaziranga is crisscrossed by four rivers. Brahmaputra, Diplu, Moradipu and Moradanshri. Third is also not correct. Kuntipula River that flows through the Silent Valley. Yes or no? What did I say? Majority of the time match the following or the pass of the question are tricky. Yes or no? Are they tricky? Though we know Corbett National Park, Kaziranga National Park, Silent Valley, but we are not sure on the rivers on which they are located. Yes or no? Rivers on which they are located. So it is always recommended not to touch them as the following question. Of course, it is only 50-50 chances. 50-50 chances. This side will give you a relief point. But this side, it is very tricky. Why? Because Corbett. Okay. It is Ram Ganga, not Ganga. Second is Kaziranga is crossed by four rivers. It is not only Manas. And third is not correct because it is Kuntipula River that flows through Silent Valley. I think you got an enough information how to touch them as the following whenever it comes with respect to rivers. Yes or no, ma? Yes or no? Please answer me. Now, only 10 more questions to go. Only 10 more questions to go. I think I got some allergy. Kindly excuse me. I got some allergy. Fine. Only 10 questions. Consider the following organisms. Which of the above are used as biofertilizers? Very, very easy question. Nostoc is Agaricus and Spirogyra is a biofertilizer? No, it is only two. Why? Because Agaricus is a mushroom. Many of whose species are edible. Spirogyra chiefly occurs in pond, pools, ditches and similar other places. Because of the slippery feel of the thread, plant body, it is often called pond scum or water skill. Yes, ma'am. It is not generally used as a biofertilizer. Instead, if you use it, would compete with the plant. So, second is that first is a mushroom, third is not. Only nostoc is used as a biofertilizer. This again, it is like a general science question. This again is a general science question. Is this fine? Yes, ma'am. Which of the following add nitrogen to the soil? Addition of nitrogen to the soil. Give me an answer. Make an attempt. Make an attempt. Yes. Excretion of urea by animals. Is it so? And burning of coal by man. Does burning of coal by man add nitrogen to the soil? No, ma'am. Death of vegetation. True. Excretion of urea by animals. True. It is only 1 and 3 is right. Burning of coal does not add nitrogen. Is this fine? Why? When coal is burned, nitrogen helps to form the oxides which may be released as a flue gases and thereby pollute the atmosphere. It does not add nitrogen to the soil unless the oxides are so created enter into the nitrogen cycle. Then what remains after burning coal is a fly ash. Fly ash is a devoid of nitrogen content. So, the second statement is not correct. Rest two are correct. Is this clear? Is this clear, ma'am? Fine. Excuse me. Is this clear? Such an easy question. Yes. Can I move on to the next? Can I move on to the next? 42. In which of the following state is lion-tailed macaw found in its natural habitat? Did I do this in class? Please answer me. Did I do this in class? I have shown this figure. I have shown the image also. Nilgiri langur, lion-tailed macaw. Do you remember the other name of it? Nilgiri langur. Yes or no? Yes or no? Recently, I have completed this topic. In special class, please do select the correct answer using the code given below. Of course, it is A, 1, 2, 1, 3. Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Karnataka. Because Western Ghats. yes or no, nothing to do here with Andhra. The correct answer, because of the Western Ghats being its natural habitat. Yes or no, Aslam? See how easy, how much our class is helping. We are able to decode even the previous year's questions also. Nilgiri langur, very true, ma, very true. Because they are endemic to Western Ghats, not to the Andhra Pradesh. Okay, not to Eastern Ghats. Next. Next interesting question. Some Buddhist rock cut caves are called Chaityas, while others are called Viharas. What is the difference between the two? We are simply asking, what is the difference between Chaityas and Viharas? Is this fine? Yes, ma. Vihara is a place of worship, while Chaitya is the dwelling place of the monk. Wrong. Chaitya is a place of a worship, while Vihara is the dwelling place of the monk. Of course, this is right. First is interchanged. Chaitya is the stupa at the far end of the cave, while Vihara is the hall axial to it. Wrong. There is no material difference. Wrong. So, it is such an easy question. Again and again, we are proving it. Yes or no type questions are 90%. You will get the right answer and they will be made deliberately easy. Okay. Chaitya church. Vihara is a monastery. Both early Chaitya and Vihara were made by wood, and later stone cut Chaityas and Viharas were made. So initially they were made by wood, and later on only it was the stone cut architecture. So the second statement, Chaitya was a rectangular prayer hall with a stupa placed in the center, and the purpose was for prayer. Chaitya was divided into three parts and had an apsidal ending, that is a semicircular rear end. The central part of the hall, called the nave, was separated from the two axils by two rows of pillars. The Chaityas also has polished interior walls. Okay. Viharas was the residence of the monk. Simple. This comes from your art and culture portion. Of course, ancient India. Is this fine, ma? Yes. Easy question, but try to make it smart. Next, which of the following describe best the concept of Nirvana in Buddhism? What do you mean by Nirvana? It is a state of bliss and rest. Is this an extinction of flame of the desire? No. Is this the complete annihilation of the self? No. Mental stage beyond all comprehension? No. It is a state of a bliss and the rest. Yes or no? Yes, ma. Nirvana is often depicted as bliss, or the cessation of suffering, dukkha, suffering. These are all senses in accord with the basic senses of Nirvana as being a state without the conditioning aspects arising, subsisting, changing or passing. Some Westerners, however, saw Nirvana as a nihilistic goal, a complete annihilation of consciousness, a connotation that many people found troubling. Buddhists, to the contrary, insist that idea of Nirvana should not lead to despondency. Nirvana is a condition in which suffering is not present, its most appealing aspect. Nirvana, in conclusion, is the goal of the Buddhist practice and the culmination of the long process of self-cultivation. Fine, ma, this is a simple question. If you ask me, the point I wanted to register is every year, undoubtedly, each year, UPSC have the habit of asking questions from Buddhism or Jainism. Okay. They are very sure they wanted to pick one question from Buddhism. If they ask from Buddhism, they don't ask Jainism. If they ask from Jainism, no Buddhism. So from religion, you can guarantee expect this question. So it is our prime duty to prepare the topics or the facts with respect to the religion, isn't it? Such an important topic, please pay attention to it. Next is 45. According to the Constitution of India, which of the following are fundamental for the governments of the country? What are they? Which are the fundamental for the governments of the country? Is it for fundamental rights? It is for an individual. It is a fundamental duty? No. For the governments of the country, of course, it is DPSP. Isn't it? Directive principles of the state policy guide executive on how to govern. Is it so? Yes, ma'am. Such an easy question. 46. The people of India agitated against the arrival of Simon Commission because why? There was no Indian member in the Simon Commission. Yes, ma'am. This is the prime reason. Because of this only they agitated. Yes. The response to the formation of Simon Commission in India was immediate and anonymous. That no Indian should be thought fit to serve on a body which claimed the right to decide the political future of India was an insult that no Indian of even most moderate political opinion was willing to swallow. So we got. So Simon Commission, this is a very, very easy question. Nothing to talk about diarchy or nothing to talk about the working of Act of 1919. Suggested the partition. No, it is like no Indian member in the Simon Commission. Is this clear? 47. Quit India movement was launched in response to. Why there is a launch of a Quit India movement? Superma. Cripps proposal. Yes. After the failure of the Quit India was launched in response, they are not asking about Quit India. They are asking why Quit India? Why it has happened? It was launched in response to Cripps proposal. After the failure of the Cripps mission, Gandhi decided to launch his third movement against the British. This was Quit India campaign, which began in August 1942. Why it has become necessary to launch a Quit India movement in these difficult conditions when the possibility of brutal repression was certainty. For one, the failure of the Cripps mission in April 1942 made it clear that Britain was unwilling to offer an honorable settlement. Yes, either Quit India, this is a famous slogan, either we have to win in the fight against the British or we have to lose, do or die. Yes or no? A very famous quote, do or die, Quit India. So this was, if you ask me, ma'am, normally UPSC aspirants, they used to say you have to do or die. Yes, you have to do, you have to make it happen in clearing the civil service or we have to give our life. No, nothing like that. UPSC is not your life. Of course, it is only a part of your life. Do, if you ask me, I'll say do, don't die. Make it happen. Okay, make it happen. Do or die is something. Fine. Do it in such a way that it should happen. Don't die. If it doesn't matter, if it doesn't happen, means God having something. God has some beautiful destination for us or God he has some other idea for us. It is not that if you are not able to fulfill, if you are not able to attain our mission or something, it is not that we have to end up our life. So nothing like that. Please have this quote. Do, don't die. Do, find an excuses to do such things. Okay. It is not your life. It is a part of your life. Is this fine? Yes, ma'am. 48. Balance of payment of a country is a systematic record of. What is this? What do you mean by balance of payment of a country is a systematic record of? Of course. All import and export transaction of a country during a given period of time, normally a year. Yes or no? It's true. Goods exported from a country during a year. False. Economic transaction between the government of one country to another. False. Capital movement from one country to another. False. Of course, the BOP. Balance of payment. It's very easy question. Yes, it is an all import and export transaction. 49. Reserve Bank of India regulate the commercial banks in matters of. Only one more question to go. Yes, I will end the session with doing only one more question. I'll stop with 50. But I will try to register some few important points in this session. Which is the area or the topic you have to prepare focus for prelims. Okay. But I have some serious irritation now. Kindly excuse with this mannerism. Really, I'm suffering. Fine. 49. Reserve Bank of India regulates the commercial banks in matters of. Select the correct answer using the quote below. Of course, in all the matter. Liquidity of the assets, branch expansion, merger of the bank, winding up of banks. Yes, everything comes under the regulation of RBI. RBI regulates liquidity assert via SLA because it doesn't have. What they are asking for? Which of the correct statement using the code given below? Right. Fine. And amalgamation, final answer is D. Thus, yes. True. Last, an increase in the bank rate generally indicates. Increase in the bank rate generally indicates, of course, central bank is following a tight monetary policy. Yes or no? Market rate of interest is likely to fall? No. Central bank is no longer making loans to commercial bank? No. Central bank is following an easy money policy? No. It is purely central bank is following a tight monetary policy or money policy. Is this clear? Yes, ma'am. Bank rate equal to RBI lends money to its clients for a long-term loans, tight monetary. So you go through this. I think it's high time for me to give some important points. Is this fine? Fine. Okay. Shall I give some topic specific? Which are the topics you have to focus subject wise? Can I do that, ma'am? 51 to 100, we will be doing light. Okay. So, fact based. During revision time, what are the area you have to focus? Especially with respect to facts and concepts. Few I will do now, remaining I will do tonight. Okay. First, we have to gather facts on international grouping. Friends, please note it down or listen to it. International groupings. What are they? Very, very important with respect to focus on. Focus on Asia Pacific. International grouping, especially focus on Asia Pacific. Is this fine? Asia Pacific. Second, important reports. Important reports by IMF. World Bank, World Economic Forum, okay, UN, OECD, and WIPO. Is this fine, ma? Before the prelims, okay? International grouping, especially we should have gained an idea, we should collect the details with respect to Asia specific. Okay, Asia specific one. Next is important reports, and third is amendment and important articles. Amendments and very important articles. Recent amendments, the year which you are going to appear. Okay, is this fine? Fourth one, of course, I'll make it short. Rivers and tributaries. Fact-based area. Rivers and tributaries. Okay. And mountain ranges. Don't worry, I'll cover all these in my map class, but this is a total summary for prelims. Soil types and forest percentage, forest cover, forest percentage, okay, state wise, forest cover percentage state wise. Is this fine, ma? Next, fifth, monsoon El Nino La Nina phenomena. Just before the exam, please brush up this topic. Very, very important. Okay, the list, hold it, ma. Such an important list I'm giving now. Friends, please give me an answer. Next is important national parks Of course, here we will be attaching important national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, biosphere reserves, wetlands. For sure, they have the habit of asking mangrove areas. Mangrove, definitely wetland mangroves, yes. Ramsar sites. Okay, biosphere reserves. So, environment, these things you know already. Elephant reserves, all these things what we have discussed. Tiger reserves, national park, tiger reserves. Though this list you have to brush up just before the exam. Next, 7. Government schemes, environmental organization and summits. Environmental organization. Okay, and summits. Then 8 is government schemes. I think 2016 we have more than 10 to government schemes. Yes or no, ma? Yes or no? Did we discuss government schemes specific to women, children, disabled, rural development? Majority, all the government schemes, recent government schemes which has released on that year. Is this fine? Next, I'm just giving an idea only. Map, very, very, very important. Prelims, of course, from geography, it will be map dominated, and maps are very important. Focus on Asia, especially Southeast Asia and West Asia. They have the habit of asking more questions from Southeast Asia and Europe. Europe and Africa. Very important, ma. See, less question you get from Australia and other places. Whereas Asia, Europe and Africa, it is the dominated. These are the core areas. Budget highlights. Okay. And economics summary. 10th point. Budget highlights. And economic summary. Fine. Economic survey. Is this point? Many, especially in economic survey, we have to focus on terms. Yes or no? Yes or no? They have the habit of asking the terms from economic survey. So, terms from economic survey. Then 11th is major tribal region, major tribal group, major tribal groups. Is this fine, ma? Is this fine? Don't worry, this is general. I have for each subject what you have to brush up for geography, what you have to brush up for history, environment. I think, can I do for one more? Can I do for one more? Rest I will do it in tonight class. Okay, one more information I will register here. Remaining the subject specific, we will push it to tonight. We have 8 to 10, right? Now I will do only one more. Because I have some this allergy problem, I can't hold more time. Yes, ma. Okay, which you want me to do? Can I do for... Please answer me. Can I say for polity? Of course, it's simple. Okay. 2017 only they have asked. Or can I give for history? Of course, history list is huge. Indian economy, I have medieval India, for all subjects. For all subjects we have. Let us do only one now. Rest I'll do it tonight. Okay. We do polity. Okay. Fine. Brush up this topic from polity, especially give focus first and foremost is important to fundamental rights. Okay. Of course. Followed by DPSP, preamble, and of course FD. This is one part easy. Parliament is see. If any candidate who is strong in FR and Parliament, FR and Parliament is very, 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 very important. Majority of the questions comes from Parliament and FR, especially from Parliament. Yes or no? Then Union Government, of course, Executive. Here you have to focus on President. Undoubtedly, President with respect to all powers. President, Executive powers, Legislative powers, Judicial powers, Discretionary powers, pardoning powers, all powers with respect to president, such an important topic. Okay, if you're going to do president, definitely have to brush up with the governor. Every year you can see the word governor printed in your question paper. How many of you have admired that they have the habit of asking question from governor? Okay, and of course prime minister, central council of minister, legislature. Here we have parliamentary and functions. Parliament functions and committees. Parliamentary committees. Parliamentary committees. How many of you have read this? Very, very important topic. Of course, speaker, pro tem speaker. Speaker. Pro tem speaker. Here again, this is an important topic. Judiciary. So first you try to finish FR, Parliament, Judiciary. 70% of your job is done here itself. Supreme Court, High Court, everything, and other powers and functions, other subordinates, courts, all. Local government, for sure you have to focus on it, because it is an explicit topic mentioned in your syllabus. Panchayati Raj and municipalities. Yes or no? So I think majority of the students will skip this part, local government, since it is exclusively added, being added in your revised syllabus, UPSC revised syllabus, local government. They'll ask a question on this topic. Please give focus on this local government. Okay. And the reason amendment, very, very, very important. Recent amendments, undoubtedly they will ask questions from this area. Is this fine? Yes, ma. The trend analysis from 2010. Okay, if you are going to compare from polity, okay, the last, just give me 1 minute. 2010, okay, polity alone. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, of course, 15, 16, and 17. This is the pattern, okay? From 2010 till, we can drop till 19 also. 18, 19, you know what is the status. Here it is 8 questions, 9 questions. 2012 it was 18 questions. 2013 it was 16 questions from polity. 14 it was 12. 15 it was 12. 16 they asked only 5 questions. Okay. Only 5 questions, and 17 they have asked 22 questions. So what the students have been preparing for 8, 10, yes, 8, 9, 18 questions 2012. So Definitely 2013 also they emphasize the focus more on polity. Polity, undoubtedly, you can round about 12 questions, 12 to 13 questions, just to keep you in tension or to give you the wrong opinion. See, 2016, they scaled down, only they have asked 5 questions. So, the students were preparing for 2017, they thought, chalo, I think only 5 questions or 6 questions from polity. Let us not focus more. To break that assumption or the opinion you have with respect to UPSC. UPSC is not under our assessment, okay? It is an uncertain exam. In order to break that opinion, they have increased 5 times, okay? From 5, they have asked 22 questions in 2017. So it's my humble request that don't come to any conclusion with respect to UPSC. No, this subject they will ask only 5 questions or 20 questions. No, don't overdo or underdo. Don't overemphasize. Give a balanced approach for the core subjects. Yes, undoubtedly you will have 10 questions or 12 questions from polity. So this is how we have to do the subject analysis. That we'll be doing it very recently. Don't worry, ma. Today class is the last class. Tonight I'll try to share the input specific to ancient India, medieval India, modern India. Is this fine? Because history also you wanted to have an idea. So specific to history, I'll try to give more inputs. Now with this, I'm stopping the session. 50, we have done the discussion till 50. From 51 to 100, along with input specific to history, I will try to cover in tonight class 8 to 10 p.m. Okay, until then, it's bye from your DL ma'am. Good luck, good day, bye bye. Stay connected. Hope this session helped you. Of course, hereafter, I'm not going to decode, hereafter, I'm not going to do anything with respect to prelims. Is done. After that, I'll start with the topics because I'll start with the subjects. Yes, we have long way to go. I'll be starting the Indian geography and I'll also try to bring other subjects in. Hope this session helped you greatly. Yes, ma'am. I'll catch you tonight after a short break. Until then, it's bye from your DL ma'am. Yes, it's highly time for you to use my code and take the subscription. Kindly excuse me. Kindly accept my apology. Today I have a bad infection. Because of that only some change in the mannerism. Kindly excuse. I have managed the last 2 hours with a little bit irritation. I got some allergy. I have to go and check with that. Thank you one and all. Yes, ma. Promise tonight I'll give you the inputs with respect to history. Okay. Thank you. Yes, ma. I'll catch you tonight, 8 p.m. Fine, ma. Until then, it's bye from your DL, ma. Good luck. Good day. Bye-bye. Stay connected. Yes, Navin. Thank you so much.